I'm going to talk about group dynamics. Before talking about the group dynamics, what is group? What are the characteristics is represented by the group? And which are the factors may influence for the group formations? And what is the stages of the forming the group formations? These are things I may discuss one by one. So we'll discuss one by one. So the first one, what is group? Generally, the group, no? So we cannot be called a single person as a group. So when we grouping with two or three people, when you combine with two or three people only, we may call us here the group. See the case, you are called as an MMAT first year student. So why you are called as an MMAT first year student? MMAT first year students represent the entire 30 students of the MMAT first year batch students. It is not single person representation. Okay, altogether only we are called as an MMAT first year students. Therefore, each individual having the, you have some kind of agenda, you have some kind of purpose to continue the MMAT. Therefore, that is why you are our university having the chance for you to develop some kind of grouping as a MMAT students. Now you have the lot of collaboration happen because when you joined as a MMAT students, particularly now everything is a virtual mode. So you have a lot of confusion or a lot of conflict may arise between the group members before 1 month or when they start the programs. But now you are understood that who is the other persons. So what are the plus point, what are the negative for others? See, everything now you realize it. Because how we realize in the sense, because of the this much of the classes we organize through the online mode, you got some kind of expertise. From the experience, you got who is that Sana, who is the Kavita, who is other people, who is Muhammad and all. So now you find some of the unique features of the each individuals. I hope now you understand the each persons. I hope each of the class members of the MMAT badges, you may know who are the others of your group members and all. So in this case, the group is a collection of people who have a common purpose. So see, in the case of the MMAT student, you have the common purpose to finish the MMAT with first class or a distinctions. And parallelly, we have some other objectives or interact or perform with each other to accomplish the group objectives. So whenever you are assigning any kind of group work, so that group has some kind of objectives or some kind of goal is there. So once up to the goal reaching, we can work together. That is called grouping. That is a basic definition of group. Just I'm moving to the next one. So what are the characteristics of the group? The first characteristics, two or more persons. The first characteristic of the group is two or more persons. What it means, because we cannot be called a single person as a group. So if you found the people more than two or three, then only we may call as a group. So it is not even. In our classrooms, it consists of 30 students. But when you deeply look onto the 30 students, we have the different groups. So like some fun groups, like entertainment groups. Like this, you have different groups you may form. That's called friendship groups. Normally, in your case, you have the close friends you may found out from your MMAT badges. Now you are connecting with each other. So in this manner, you are finding, you are making some kind of group in the 30 students itself. And the groups having the formal social structure. What is formal social structure in the sense? Even for the case of the cricket, they already having the some who is the bowler, who is the batsman, who is the all-rounder, who is the captain. So even the cricket team consists of the 11 players, but all the 11 players having some kind of specific structures of them. So always the wicket keeper, stand back to the stump. And the bowler is opposite to the opposite to the keeper. So like that, there is some kind of structural role they have. They are playing that one. So therefore, every group having some kind of social, some kind of structural things is there. And the next is a common fact. So there is a proverb is there: sing or sing together. Generally, if the teams is lost, for example, the last games India won. So what it means, it's not an individual person win, it is a whole, the teams won the game. So here, if the won is happen or win is happen, it's the credit goes to the team member only. If the team is lost, the entire fat is going, entire negative means goes to the entire team member only. So therefore, the common fat to the all the group members, then they are playing for the common goals only. So what is the common goals of the Indian cricket team? They want to win the each games. That is a common goal. Then even the common goal, they specifics also, without the face-to-face interaction of the group member, nothing's to be materialized and nothing's to be moved. Therefore, the face-to-face interactions are basic characteristics of the grouping. Then interdependency, this is much important. So even the cricket team, lot of players are very good. They have their own identity. But when you're going for the field, no, they won't showcase their own individual difference. They are working together only. So it means that they're dependent with each other. The dependent of the success of one person depends on the other person. In the case of the cricket, no, when the people are playing batting, the opposite, so one person batting, other person, if they run properly only, he may get the run. Otherwise, the opposite person, those are standing out, no, the same team. So when they cross the each one only, they may get the score, single run. Suppose the person, those who are opposite to play, opposite end, that person is not collaborate with me and they are not coordinate with me properly, I may go for the run out. So that kind of issues may happen. Therefore, each player's success may depend on the other members only. Therefore, interdependence with each other. Then finally, their main characteristics recognized by others. So each member can accept the other members. Suppose there is a difference or conflict may happen between the team members or group members, there is no success may happen. So some egos, lot of why the some of the institutions, they are not success enough in the sense because of the egos. The people having much egos, they could not be and lead further as a group board. Should the exact characteristics of the grouping. And just I know to the process or stages of the group development, this may come to your exam also. How they generally the group formation happen or the stages of the group formation. So here there is a 5 stages. Even this question may come to the NET examination also. The stages of the are framing the groups. There is a 5 steps. One is called forming, storming, norming, performing as well as the observing. So what is forming? See, in the case of I am taking is the example of your MMAT batch. Okay. So when you join. And the first day of the MMAT, that's called forming. So you form the group as a MMAT first year students. Then after this, you have a lot of storming may happen. That storming is nothing but a conflict. So a lot of disparity, a lot of differences, you may find it from the other members. So when joining, it's about within 1 week or 10 days, you have a lot of conflict or who is a big person, who is a small one. A lot of deviations may happen between the each group members. That is called storming. Then after storming, you are moving to the norming. Now you realize that, so what is your norms? What is the role of the MMAT students? Now you have to write an examination of the first semester, then you can go with the second year, second semester. Like that you are fixing some norms, what is your exact goals? For this you are leading. So therefore, the storming issues, no, in the second stage, now it's reducing now. Now you realize your the exact nature of work, what is your assigned thing, what things you are going to do further, everything you can fix the norms from your end itself. Then finally you are performing to reach your target. That end of the performance, so once the entire 4 semesters will be over, the entire MMAT batch may adjourn. So because your work is to be over, you got the certificate, then after finishing your MMAT program, each one's going to a different directions. Once they have the chance, you meet with each other. Because the partially your work is to be total work, because you got the MA degree, therefore you will divide the group. That group may split it or they may be scattered because the goal is to be fulfilled. So this is the way that this is the way normally the groups may happen. See the example which I organized previously. I told to be draw one diagram with the use of the Google Jamboard. What he did, so I am already formed the groups. See the first stage. So what I did as a teacher, I can form the group. So without your concern, therefore you have to act. You have to accept the group formation one, because here I'm make this grouping. Suppose you like to create a group. Suppose I'm giving the freedom to create the group by yourself. You also having the rights to create a group. So that's also forming. Then after the forming, the second step, what you found, what you find from the activity which I assigned from you. Previously, you have a lot of confusion may arise, who is going to start this particular diagram and what is my role. Lot of confusion may arise. So even some of the group members, you don't be much close with each other. Therefore, you have some kind of conflict may arise. How can I direct them or how can I work under him? Like a lot of storming, a lot of conflict, even you may think during the time which I'm asking the work. So that is called conflict stage, that is called storming stage. Then after this, particularly the second group, what they did, they assigned the work. They're assigned, I'm going to color, you are going to draw. Like that, you are assigning some of the tasks for the each group members. The task is assigned by the group leader, or even the members of the each individual can assign their works by themselves. That is called norming. After fixing the norming, what they you did in the case of the previous example, you start to draw. You start to draw, that is called performing. So once you start to performing, 100% should be over in the sense, then I given the concluding remarks. After giving the concluding remarks, you are not watching the Google Jamboard now, because the group is task be over. Once the group task is over, you have to go with the different mode. Okay, therefore, you could not be having the connection now with the group members, because the task is to be fulfilled from your end. So that is called adjourn. So this is the way every groups, this is the stage or the cause of the grouping. Just I'm going to show one more video related to the example, related to this group development, the stages. In the case of stage two, it's called storming. So here the members come to resist control by the group leaders and show their hostility to each one. In the case of the norming, the group members can divide the work and they may get some kind of close relation and feeling and focusedness may develop this particular stage. Then based on the norming, they are going to implement in the base of the performing mode. Then finally, they are going to understood their success. Then they may leave from the groups. That is called adjourning. So I will go one by one. The forming is the first stage. For forming the life of the group, it's the first stage. At this stage, the members try to know each other and establish common understanding among them. So even when they start, they connect with each other, immediately we like to find who is the other members. Immediately we are asking that, who is he, what is the name, what is the background, that kind of common identification we need. That's why we are giving our credential. We are also inviting the other members' information also. So they struggle to clarify the group goals. Particularly, they could not be explain the group goals, because the forming stage, a lot of conflict, I already mentioned, no? Even the storming also, the conflict may happen, because sometimes the forming stage, they don't have the belief with other members. Therefore, they struggle to clarify the group goals as well as they determine the appropriate behavior within the groups. The forming stage is completed once individual, with the group feel that they are truly the members of the groups. So sometimes, so even some people know after 1 year also, they would not get some kind of grouping. So because of their attitude, because of their behaviors. So therefore, each individual behavior may contribute for the success of the groups. The second one is called storming. It's the second stage of the group formation. The name implies, even the name implies, the stage is characterized by considerable amount of the conflict. At this stage, group members try to resist for being controlled by the group very often. The members disagree. Sometimes the members may disagree with others' comments about who should lead the groups. So a lot of confusion arises that who is lead the group. So I won't be act as a subordinate for him. Like a lot of controversy or conflict may happen in this particular stage. They also have the different opinion over how much power should leader of the group have. And this stage is completed when the group members no longer resist the group's control and their mutual understanding and agreement about who will lead the group. So even for finding the leader of this group also takes much time in this particular stage. Normally this stage is completed when group members consider that it's better to work together for the achievements of the group goals. So this is second stage. The third stage is called norming. In the case of the norming, generally the people may divide the work. So the group members really start feeling that they are blanks to the group. So here only the we feeling may start. We feeling of the group. Then they develop very close intimacy and relation with one another. A feeling and friendship develops among them in this stage. A well-developed sense of common purpose of the group emerge among the members. In this stage, group members agree on standard to guide the behavior in a group. Even the members begin to take greater responsibility for their own group and relationship, while the authority figure becomes relaxed. So here, each member can fix their own work. Even the leader may assign the work, the subordinates may accept the work. So like this, some kind of norming, the rules, the formations may happen to this stage. The fourth stage is called performing. So in this stage, fully functional group, where the members see themselves as a group and get involved in the task. So each member, they may involve, they may give 100% of the work. Then each person make a contributions, and the authority figure is also seen as a part of the group. And when this stage reaches, a group is ready to tackle all types of group tasks. So that is a great things in the case of the stage. The last one is called adjourning. So the adjourning represent, I already mentioned, no? So the group disbands after having the accomplished goals. However, ongoing work groups is organized don't go through this stage. Rather, they remain at their performing stage. So suppose if the temporary groups like a project work or task force or any other small activity which they completed fulfilling the sense, immediately they may go, they leave the groups, they may do for the other works and tasks. So that is called adjourning. The next one, the types of groups. So in the case of the types of groups, generally we can categorize the types of groups into two. One is called formal group, other one is called informal group. In the formal group, it's like a command group, task group, or functional. So some kind of structural oriented. This group having some kind of structure. In the case of the informal, there is no structure. You cannot find any structure. Even the friendship, that kind of, it's called as here, informal group. See, our department, there is a formal group. So our department having a dean, HOD, then professors, associate professor, assistant professor, like this, some kind of structure is there. Therefore, it may come to the command based. Some kind of formal, the grouping formation may be there. See the case of the university. So the university lead by the vice chancellor. Then after the registrar and controller of examination, after that each department dean, each school's dean. Then after this, the main role is taken by the HOD. Then the faculty member. Then student. Then finally is non-technical. Like this, some kind of structurally. If the groups is forming, then it's called as a command groups. So, but in the case of informal, we cannot make it any kind of, we cannot find any kind of structure. Like recently, I saw some of the Facebook, even the recently Sana came to our department. Then the day itself, I can see this, the Facebook, some of the photos from Sankhya Mitra as well as the Sana's photos in the Facebook. So it means that she's from somewhere. But once she reached here as a Kerala, she connected with her friend and they went for the some places and they took the photos on that. Similarly, once it comes from one part, immediately you can find the person who are related to you or they are very close to you and you are going to their homes, you are enjoying with them. So that kind of informal way, if you collaborate with each other, then it's called as an informal group. So just I move to the formal groups, description I'm getting given here. The command group are specified by the organization chart and often consist of a supervisor and the subordinate that report to that supervisor. So it is a collection of employees who report the same supervisor. The existence of formal groups is represent on organization chart as a department. See this case of the our university, we have the different finance section, academic section, administration, like the lot of sections are available. But in the case of the commanding authority of our universities, only the vice chancellor, then registrar. So that commanding structures may be there. In the case of task group, this is the second formal group. Here we can organize that group. They form the group only for to fulfill the task. Particularly recently, our university organized the foundation day ceremony, foundation day program. That day, the vice chancellor, what he did, he fixed some kind of committees to organize the particular event. So once the particular program is over, the committee totally collapses because no one can do the same, the assigned work previously of this particular committee, because the work is over. Therefore, we are doing the regular works now. So previously, there is a specific task. For fulfilling the task, the university has in some kind of group. From this, we are working. So that is called task group. See the case. So when you go for the designing our curriculum, we can invite some kind of subject experts. Once they design, so they may come for one day, they may discuss, they may give a lot of input. Finally, they give the final syllabus. Once they form the final syllabus, they may go to their works. They may go to their place and they do their work. They won't concentrate of our department syllabus here. So it means that the task fulfilled. Therefore, they can go with the regular works. they won't concentrate the assigned work to them, because the task is over. So the task force consists of the people who work together to achieve the common task. Members are brought together to accomplish the narrow range goals within a specific time period. So in the case of the functional group, the functional group, they can work continuously. So see this university, if you want to approach for the examination, you can approach the control of exam commission. Suppose you have the doubts about your admission process, you can approach to the admission academic session. Suppose you have the issues in the payment fail, then you can approach the finance section. So like this, there is kind of some kind of functional grouping organized by our university. It's like a structure. So even the functional, in our university, we have the FO, that is the finance officer. In town, there is a DR and deputy registrar is there. Yeah, under the DR, lot of finance, department faculties may work in, the non-teaching faculty may work in. Therefore, that particular group, we have the different subsections, but each group is working for the function. Even, see, our university having more than 27 departments. Each department is a function, because we are running the program M1 PhD. If you take the consideration of the English department, they are running the English, MA English and Comparative Literature, and they are organizing the PhD program. So, like that, each department having the function. Suppose this year the MED is over, we cannot be stop our department. No, it may lead to the next level also. So next year also we are going for admission. Then we are doing the same process. It may be rotation. It may go into the circle wise. That is called functional group. There is a separate group is there, but the group, the task is over. They could not be, close the group and they can do the regular. No. It is a functional. Always their function same one. It may work is to become as a cyclone. Then the last one, the next one is called informal group. In the case of the informal group, the interest group, members with a common interest like study, cultural, gaming groups. So suppose you are very much interested to music. So automatically you may connect with some of the music peoples. Those who are linked with the music. So that your interest may lead to connect with some of the group members, that is called interest groups. Then in the case of the friendship group, so friendship groups are formed by the members who enjoyed similar social activity or political beliefs or religious values or common bonds. Even some people are the same religion, or some people know always taking the lunch with some particular group on it, because they are very much comfortable with them. Wherever they go, going for somewhere, they may go with the people only. Even I found that one of my relatives, he is always going to church with some other group member. When he go for cinema theater, he is going with other members. When he going to the other states as a tour, it can depends on the other group members. So like this, we have the different group members in a different context. And the finally is a reference group. The reference group is a type of group that people use to evaluate themselves. The main objectives of reference group are seek to social validation and social comparison, particularly the committee or volunteer groups. See, there, when the Kerala affected by the flood, immediately our university students, they started a firefight. There is a one association they started. Now it's going on well. So that is called voluntarily they form one group. Still the group is working in a very good manner. It's like a friendship group one. But they have they are doing some kind of volunteer service. Those who are having the broad vision to do help for the others, they are going to join that particular group. So that may come to the informal group. And this also, the questions may come sometimes. In what way the group formation may affect? So in the case of the factors of the group formations, one is the psychological background may influence the group formation. For example, if you have the your interest and others' interests are reflected same, you are going to frame the groups. Suppose your way of interest to be differ, other people not having the interest in the particular area, you could not be mingled with them. Therefore, the psychological things related to attitude, personality and perception may also influence in the case of the group formation. So it may influence the group formations. In the case of the social structures, like individual also form join a group based upon the social class, like caste and religions, to satisfy their social needs. They do it primarily for satisfying the love, affections and care needs. which initially they feel deprived after leaving their families. See, this is the generally when you go for the Saturday, there is people may go to the Saturday mosque, or when they go for temple, they may go. Some people having the temple friend, church friend, and the theater friend. Like this, that social based, even the case based or religion based also simply became some kind of group formation may happen. Then the next one is called security. Sometimes for security reason also we may join with some unions or association and stuff. Even our university having the two faculty association. Because of the securityness, we are joining into some association. So as an individual, sometimes one can feel insecure over unexpected development, such as sudden health problems or termination or suspension, or the local problems, etc. Therefore, everyone's like to be in a group to feel secure to work. Especially in the new place for the new employee, the security need could they may join with one association. Then only the workers may go smoothly. Then the next one is called economic. The economic is also a main factor. So generally, the economic factors, like when the individual work in an organization, he or she gets all type of economic incentives and benefits available within the rules and regulations. Sometimes organizations cannot meet an individual accidental or obligatory needs like money for marriage, house construction or medical care and other purpose. So he or she gets associated with those people who help him or her in a time of a need. Even some of the friends know, they may approach for the LIC. Because the LIC based, we may get some benefit, or they also may get some benefit. Therefore, whenever we think to go for the LIC, we are giving the LIC policy to some of the agency. That agent people's very close, listen, we are approaching them. So that also is making some kind of grouping. Then the cultural, like region, society and language. Suppose when I found any people from Tamil Nadu, I'm so happy to talk with them. So because the culture, the language also may much influence to make your forming. And the next is the proximity. So generally, the proximity is the main aspect to create a friendship with the group members. So we are good contact with our neighbors. Those are sitting with the next to your bench, you are very close to them. Like that, we have that some kind of proximity also may influence. Proximity is nearness. So in the case of sit, stay, eat, discuss, in this lot of mode, it may be involved in the case of the formation of the group formations. Just I move to the group formations. This theory, there is a four theory based only the group formations to be forming. One is called proximity theory. So I already mentioned that the proximity is the nearness. So the peoples may join with each other based on the geographical or nearness, those who are sitting near to them. From this, they create some kind of close bond. That close bond making a grouping. In the case of activity theory, like a common occupation interest, for example, whenever I'm going to present a conference or a seminar, I can connect with the people, those are from the education department, because I am working in the education department, others also the same occupational interest, education background, I may easy to connect with them. So therefore, the activity, a similar task, a similar department, it may having these some kind of closeness. Then benefit theory, suppose I'm getting some kind of gain and rewards or power or leaderships. I'm very close to the VC, the VC may give some kind of preference for me. Therefore, some people, they always going to connect with the VC and all, because of the power, because of the getting some kind of high post. So they are going to make some kind of grouping to get some benefit from them. And the balance theory, suppose the people having the same thoughts like or dislikes or beliefs they have, even see the political, this is a basic example of political party. The political party, my political party, my interest of political party is same to the other members. I'm easy to connect with them because my interest is interest to be same, like same attitude. No? So therefore, the balance theory also may influence in the case of the group formation. Just I move to the group dynamics. Within 10 minutes, I finish it. Okay. In the case of the group dynamics, the term which is developed by the Kurt Lewin, the dynamics represent force. Exactly, the group dynamics represent the attitudes and behavior patterns of the group. Because the group success may depend on the attitudes and behavior of the group. So if the attitude or behavior of the group is not at all good, they could not get success at any cost. because each one's having the ego. Some departments you can find that each faculty member having a lot of ego, due to that the department not having any growth at all, because the group dynamics zero in this case of the particular department. Similarly, if the good department having the each faculty member very close to each other, they have very good understanding, and in the sense the department having the very good upliftment may happen because of the closeness, because of the group mindset. So this is called as a group dynamics. For success of any group things like a team events, that is why the India teams regularly continuously they want success, they win the lot of crickets, because of the group dynamics of this particular group having a good because they can understand to each other, and they cannot play for a single person success, they are playing for the entire group success. So due to that only they are reaching, and our Indian teams continuously want. And see some of the comics I'm going to show, but in the Indian context what has happened, even we are talking about the team, we are talking about the team work, but see finally what it happened. One, he's called as an our thing is very formal, so our particularly our grouping in the case of institutions very formal, but the problem with the formal based grouping, so each one having the designation, okay, so each one having the designation, each one having the power, the problem with the lowest person, no, is only affected to what lot, other member just supervising, so there is no need for supervising this much of people. But all the people are doing the same role as supervising, but the designations to be different. See the designation of him is called human resource manager, he's called marketing manager, he's a logistics manager, he's a communication manager, he's an internal supervisor, he's a project manager, PR manager, product manager, and security manager. Why this much of managers needed? This is a problem in the case of the our Indian context. So the work, that is why the work wise we not get 100% perfect. Only 1 or 2% are working, other members those are sitting in the top, no, they are not at all working, they are doing only the supervising work. Due to that only it happened. Sometimes the team work is not be good. What it happened, see this, this an image is showing the issues of this. See this image. Even it's a teamwork. Suppose this team is working in one end, this team is working with the different end. There's a two teams working together. But the problem, one team, train bridge is a train, things it comes here. Okay, the platform. So other one is here. So how it will be work out? So because if the lot of people, that's why there is a proverb, is that so many cooks spoil the food. So many cooks spoil the food. If the leader is only one, they can easily to direct the both the groups to lead perfectly. Otherwise, this kind of issues may happen. See this. It is not a comics, it's really happened here. See this, there's a real incident happened. One person did like this, one group member, the other group is doing like this. Therefore, the entire money waste only here in this context. And generally the features of group dynamics, having, there is a five group features are there. The features I may list out here now. The features of the first feature is called concern with the group. So we have to concern. So when you go to do anything, we have to discuss with the group member. Otherwise, some kind of ego may happen to the group member. So always be cautious before doing any. If you want to develop a group dynamics, as a, suppose if you are acted as a leader or if you are as a subordinate, you have to ask the permission from the head, or you can mingle with your subordinate. Finally, you can go for the implementation work. That is called concern with the group. Each member we have to concern. Group dynamic is concern with the group. Wherever a group exists, the individual interact and members are continually changing or adjusting relationship with respect to each other. The members of the group may interact, maybe in the state of distinction, or maybe attract or repel for each other, may seek the resolutions of distinctions and return to equilibrium after the resolutions. Therefore, we have to give much concern to each member. And second one is called changes. Actually, our Indian context, sometimes the leader always, he may leave for 10 years, 20 years and all. But generally, it may be rotation. That is why even our university having the pattern that HOD maximum 3 years only. So once our Amritsar is a HOD now. So he's going to finish within 7 months he's finishing the 3 years of experience of the HOD. After that, it may go to the next person as HOD. It's like a rotation. That is for changes. Generally, in the case of the any kind of group, there should be a rotation, should be there. Rotation. Otherwise, the group growth won't be there. So that is why the university, all the university having some kind of stability norm that the HOD dean, the post should be rotation. Even the vice chancellor post need not be sit more than 10 years. He's having maximum 5 years on in the case of the vice chancellor. So that is called changes. The changes go on occurring like introduction of new members, sometimes new faculty member change, or changes in leadership, or presence of old and new members, and rate of changes are fast and slow. So the groups may dissolve if the members are not enthusiastic about the goals. They have no faith in their ideology and don't identify themselves with the groups. This means that cohesiveness of the group is decreased. So monophility will be happen if the rotation is not there. Exactly. So because that is why in the context of the India, particularly in the higher education, there is a rotation system they are following properly. So even as a student, when I joined as a student professor, every 5 years or every 4 years, we have some kind of promotions. Because once it started as an assistant professor and died with assistant professor, is not at all a good. Therefore, they are going with some kind of changing some order is there. So everywhere the job also some kind of order. Like I'm going to the 10th pay, then I'm going to the 11th matrix or 12th matrix salary. There is some kind of increase. So everything should be changeable in the case of the higher education. Otherwise, there is no growth may happen. The rigid and flexibility, they may be rigid and flexible. Sometimes the leader may be very rigid in some contexts. Sometimes should be flexible. So if you're always rigid, nothing should be moved in the case of the group work. So sometimes we should be, as a team leader, should be flexible. We can adjust with the family, team members. We can adjust with the team leaders. A lot of flexibility and rigidity is needed in the case of the group dynamics for lead the group dynamics properly. And group organization, the group organization is essential because it leads to greater group effectiveness, participation, cooperation, and constructive morale. The leader will be effective only if the group member is organized in state. Suppose if we could not have some kind of structural organization or structural order is not there, that is why our department, we are giving us a timetable. So suppose I am taking the fourth unit, other faculties are taking the fourth unit, what is the need? That's why we are dividing our work in some kind of organized format. So this is a time, that's why we are framing the timetable and we are dividing the work for the each member. Even we are taking as a team teaching. The team teaching also, we divide the things very, very structured manner we are organizing with the leadership of the our HOD as well, team. Because they are directing that we have to go with the sequential, we have to go with some organized mode. So due to that only there is no happen, there is no replications may happen in the case of the content delivery. Then last one is called continuous processes. So in the case of the group dynamics, it's really continuous process. Suppose today I finish the task, so tomorrow also I don't consider the group things, and it's not be fair. Because every time the group department work may comes, so tomorrow is the NAC work, day after tomorrow, within after 5 years, there's one more NAC work. Like this, then very soon we are going to face the online examination. We are going to evaluate. Therefore, the work may comes in a different mode. And it's like a continuous process. The work of the group is to be a continuous process. The dynamic group always a continuous process of restructuring, adjusting and readjusting the members to one another for the purpose of reducing the tensions, eliminating the conflict and solving the problem which is the members have the common. So this is the features of group dynamics. Yes, this is a question may come as a big question. This is my final presentation of my slide. One is called, it's not a slide because the other slides also related to this. Which are the factors affecting the group behavior or group dynamics? So previously I'm talking about the factors factors influencing the group formation. This is a group behavior or group dynamics. One is called group resources. So the first one is called group resources. Suppose I have five group members. The five group member not having the ability to do the work, then finally the entire group has to be based on it. So no can fill it properly. Therefore, the ability and the proficiency of the group member also may influence the success of the group. Suppose only the leaders may work, other members are not working. So therefore, we cannot be fulfill the group work conduct. Therefore, the group dynamics may disturb a lot. Then the group structure. In the case of group structure, even the size may influence the roles which are assigned to be influenced, norms which forms influence, cohesiveness of the group. So everything may influence in the case of the group structure. The group process, like some people that communicate perfectly, it may lead the group things properly. Sometimes the conflict management is needed. Because in the case of the uni system and all, we have more than 120 faculties and more than 100 non-teaching faculties are there. So it's like a very big people, very wide people are there, or human people are involved. Therefore, generally what it happens, that conflict may happen to the each member. Therefore, as a head, as a vice chancellor, he can manage the conflict among the faculty member. Then only it may go in a perfect manner. The leadership also make much influence in the case of the group dynamics. Suppose we got the very poor leader in the sense, we cannot lead further because nothing may happen to the department or nothing will happen to the university and that. Because of the leadership also, our group task may work. Then finally, the group task, sometimes the task may be very complex, very complicated, we cannot be finished it. Then each one's, the task, we have to depend on someone in the sense, the person which assign the work is not fulfilled in the sense, it may affect the group behavior. So in this manner, the factors may affect it. Just I'm moving to the one slide. This slide is talking about how the Indian system is going on. Just for joke, I'm showing this one. So this is a slide I found it from the online only. This is like a PowerPoint slides. This is like a race, okay. So sometimes maybe happen also that you are showing this one. Once upon a time, there was an Indian rowing team. Once upon a time, it's like a story based. Once upon a time, there was an Indian rowing team. India and Japan agreed to do annual rowing race. Each team should contain 8 men. So each team is having the 8 members. This is in India, one is in Japan. Both teams work really hard. So both the teams working very, really hard to success to get the best. This is called the example of the group behavior also. The day race started, both the teams were similar conditions. So because here also 8 members, there also 8 members. The people's caliber wise, all the 8 members of our team as well as the Japanese teams are good. But finally, the Japanese won by 1 mile. That particular year, the Japanese won by 1 mile. So see, you know, because even though they are working hard from the Indian context, Indian players, but they couldn't succeed from the Japanese. Then finally, what it happened, the mood of the Indian team was really close to freeze point. The top management decided to win the next year. So they decide to go next year and we should be winning. Like they take a submission. So they stop the team of analysts. They are going for some kind of analysis and observations on the situation. And then finally they recommend. So based on the previous experience, they give some kind of appropriate solutions, recommendations for this. So they're doing some kind of analysis of the previous year of the Indian team. Then finally, after several detailed analysis, the Japanese had finally what they find, no? They are comparing with the success team as well as the lost team. 7 rowers and only 1 captain in the case of the Japanese. So this is where the Japan's won because there is a 7 rowers and 1 captain. So of course, Indian team also 7 captain but only 1 rower. That is the issue on the day. So due to that, only India failed that match. So they find that this is a problem for the Indian because that they have the 7 rowers in the case of Japan, but in the case of the Indian, only one captain in the case of Japan. But in the case of the India, we have the 7 captain and 1 rower. And therefore, finally, they have come for one conclusion, recommendation for the next level. Therefore, the Indian teams are restructuring the Indian teams. The panel members are discussing. Then finally, they're recommending a very good one. The solution for that, instead of going with the seven captain of India team, we can go with only 4 captain and in lead by the 2 managers and 1 top manager and 1 rover. See these comparisons. So now also only 1 rovers only. Now also only 1 rovers. But previously there is a 1 seven captain, but now this split is seven captain to different texts. Only that only happened to the Indian context. Then finally see this, what it happened. The next years they went. So this is called one rovers, then one captain, then this is Indian context. Okay, then see, then finally only one person is going to row these things. The next year Japan is 1/2 miles. Then finally, once again, they analyzing the failure of the Indians. The Indian team immediately displaced the rover from the team based on the unsuccessful performance. So for who get the, what is that problem, no? Only the rovers, because the captain not having any issues, the supervisor is not having any issue, only the one person should rover, no? For him only, that is the issue. Therefore, they throw that particular person. Then finally, they asked to call for some kind of bonus offering that gives some kind of motivation or some kind of remedy to leave the next level. Then finally, they give some kind of idea that India, the team is descending new boat, because they found that the problem with the boat only, not from the people. So this is a problem in the case of the group behavior. So still, we are thinking about the designation and power only. No one can thinking about the work nature. So no one can thinking about the working nature. That is why this much problems arise. When you look onto the Indian context, most of the peoples, they like to go with higher level or the positions. They very much like to reach the high position. But once they reach the positions, they are not work for that level. That is a biggest problem. And now lot of political influence, lot of things may influence to get the positions. Now it's not going with 100% perfect way to get the positions and all. So totally the context of the Indian things is moved to the some kind of corruption world. I don't know when it will be resolved, this kind of issues. Yes, I'm going to summarize these things. Even for cheating the examination, some kind of teamwork may happen. See the teamwork of the cheating. And the first stage, this same thing I'm going to discuss. The factors affecting the group behavior, the first one is called group resources. Suppose the group resources nothing but the group member quality. If the member's knowledge, ability, skills, and the personality characteristics are the resource of the group members to bring with them. If the success depends on the resources as usual to the taskmasters, the group member having good caliber or ability to attend the work, I'm sure the group dynamics also may very healthy manner. Suppose I am not having good quality, I am always doing a politics in every activities. Nothing should be happen to the growth of the department, or nothing should be happen to the nothing should materialize also, because we have each one having different politics, we have different things there. But when you come to the work culture, we should show only our skills and only everything instead of showing the political things and all. Or the other kind of unwanted things, without showing that, we can show our skills only. Then only it may helping to the groups to be success. The second one, even see, when you're talking about team, there is I is important, because the hidden word, the I is involved. Without I, nothing should be fulfilled. Even the group success or group behavior may depends on the each individuals. Each individual. If each individuals are very good in the sense. Some kind of quality. That is why it's still our department having very close to each of us. Because therefore, I don't know about other department. We may call our department as a education family. So even the old students also very much happy to part of our any kind of department programs. Because we feeling. That we feeling, it happened because of the collegiality of the faculty member of each of us. Yes. Next is a group structure. So how the group structure may affect the group behavior in the sense, suppose the group is very small, we can easily divide the work, we can assign the work, they can work and do the things. Suppose the group is very big, 100 people, we cannot be able to control who is doing, and we cannot be watch whether all the people are doing work properly. Therefore, when we go for the higher size of the group, we cannot be able to control it. That is a biggest problem, and that is why there is a problem also, so many people spoil the food. So if you're assigning one work only fulfilled by one person, you can give the other task to the other person in a group activity. Instead of that, the same work done by the 100 people, the work may be collapsed only. then group roles, then in the formal groups, roles are always predetermined assigned the members. Suppose as a leader, we can assign some other work. Based on the assigned work, they can do. Suppose I don't like to follow the HOD directions, immediately I may fight with the HOD and it may affect the closeness of a department. So it may happen, it not be happen to our department, but I'm telling as an example, because we have that much of closeness. So we have to give some kind of respect to the head, dean, even the vice chancellor. For all of us, we have to give some respect. When they assign the work, when they assign some kind of norms, we have to follow it properly. Then group norms, then group caucus, the same, the caucusness, like the feeling, unity, it's also affect the group, in the case of the group dynamics. Then the third one is called group process. Suppose the communication, suppose I am basically from Tamil Nadu, I don't know Hindi. Suppose someone's direct me in Hindi language. So as a group leader, I cannot be understood what he is going to direct. Therefore, some kind of lacuna may happen. It may affect the entire group nature also. Therefore, the communication is much important. So when the leaders give the communication, it should very crystal clearly, he may mention in the sense. We can do lead further. Then conflict management is a process to limiting the negative aspects of conflict, particularly as a head of the department or head of the university, they have to manage the conflict of the group members. Then one is good. That is why the recently our vice chancellor invite all the faculty members to provide a food. So that can, then only that same the collegiality may happen between the each department members. Then leadership is a good leader, have a clear picture of future results, align organ strategy within the visions. And finally, the group task. The group task complexity is factor involved the complicated process of the situation. Suppose I'm giving the very complex assigned work. Suppose someone's are assigning the work to write a Hindi article. So I cannot write the Hindi article because I'm not good at all in this. So suppose someone's assigned me to take the inclusive education paper because I'm not good at the paper. So based on the assigned work, so which is my specialization, that only I may take consideration to teach. Instead of that, the HOD or someone's forced me to take this paper, how can I? Because it's very much complicated. Therefore, the group task is not be fulfilled properly. So that complexity, the interdependence. Sometimes even the group work, we have depends on, suppose one person finish only, I can be able to do the next hour. See the case of the your examinations. You are going to conduct the examination on 13th. For organizing examination of the 30 students, all the faculty members can work together because each faculty member can prepare their own questions. Then finally, they combine the questions in a different, well-structured question form. Then finally, they may share the question to the respective examiner of our department. That examiner can give the question paper on the day of examination. So like this, some kind of interdependence with each other. So we cannot put every problem with only the examiner of our department, because once we give the question only, he is able to organize the examination. No? So everyone, every task to be depends on each one. Suppose one of the teachers not giving the question paper in a proper time, then we cannot organize the examination. Therefore, it may affect the group behavior, group nature, things like that. Therefore, the group behavior is always to depends on the interdependence. And the last two slides after this, and if it is okay, really sorry to take much time. In the case of the causes of poor group dynamics, these are the reasons. One is here, weak leadership. If the leader is not totally good, then you cannot find any kind of group dynamics. It may affect the group dynamics also. Then excessive difference of authority. Some people are very high authority, so they like to control as much. So that people having this, that also may affect the group dynamics. Then blocking, some group members know, sometimes they block their process. They always aggressive. Some group members, they may aggress in this, need not do lead the further. Some group members always to highlight the negative things about their work. So instead of thinking about the positive things, they always criticizing things. So with this, any group members in a negator is not lead further. Then the withdrawal, some people know, they always not doing any work. If you're asking the work also, they may withdraw the work. So if you go like this, we cannot lead in a group dynamics proper manner. Then finally, some of the group members may act as a joker. So there is a problem with that. We cannot be show the jokeness. We cannot make it cracks all the time. Whenever it's new, we can use the joking, humor, things and all. But if you're always a joker, the group work may disturb you a lot. So this is where the poor dynamics may happen. Sometimes the people are free riding. They won't consider the other members. They can go as they like. So these are the issues to affect the group dynamics. Why this group dynamics need in the case of the education significance, education context? Because to promote the democratic activities in the case of the institutions or the schools, due to that this group dynamics is needed. And that is why even the John Dewey is propagated by the project method, because project method, it's given the scope to do the work in a group based. And the sense of we feeling is much important in the case of the social climate, to make a good social climate. And in, that is why some of the schools or some of the college, they are organizing lot of inter-school competition in sports and games. If you organize this kind of sports and games, it may helping the other members, the members of the group or the people or the students may get a lot of benefit. They may understand the different culture, and they can understand the other people's the positive and negative. Even some of the inter-school competition based on the group-based. When you go assign the group-based games or group-based activity, they have some kind of closeness happen between the group members. It may promote some kind of social intelligence also. Then they had to organize some kind of citizenship training program to develop their ethics and values and all. That is why in the schools and all, they are conducting some kind of morning assembly. To even the morning assembly, we have some common school uniform, school player. Why we are adding the sense for getting some kind of closeness between the members. Even when I studying the school days, no, nearly 1,000 students in a single schools. All the 1,000 students may stand in the morning together. That time only we may see all the students, because otherwise we may see only our group students only. So we have the lot of connections when you go for the prayer. So when you go for the morning assembly, there we can easy to see the 9th standard students, 10th standard students, and 11th students, 12th standard students. Maybe a lot of interaction may happen, and develop a sources to social maturity the children is need. And a school magazine participant in inter-school competitions much good in the case of the developing the group dynamics in the educational aspects. So thank you all.